Hello everyone, Jacquie Edwards here for Live at Lunchtime. Thank you so much for joining in. Oh, hopefully I've got enough internet connection here to make it. My internet's been quite bad lately. Anyways, so thank you so much for joining us on, I believe it's Wednesday today. I think I say that every day. I have no idea what day it is usually. So today I am focusing on getting through my weekly plan. And so that's what I just wanted to talk to you briefly about today. Is how you are making sure that you're getting everything done on time. Are you making sure that you're making the most of the time that you have during your week when you're focused on working? So, for those of you that are starting your business while working a full-time job, this is even more important. But, like I find sometimes, it's also important if you are on your own business, working in it every day, so you do have that bit more flexibility. I find that sometimes it can be quite hard to sit down and actually focus on getting the work done. So, how do you go about making sure that you can do that? The one thing that I make sure I do absolutely every week is I make a plan at the beginning of the week. So, I've just been tweaking this a little bit how I work it because I was starting to get a bit overwhelmed by all of the stuff that I need to get done. I get a bit too excited about new projects and take too many on sometimes. But it's all about really breaking those down. So, for me, what I've been focusing on doing every week is I pick the most important projects and the most important tasks in those projects to do during the week. So, I started off by just making one big massive list. So, I took like 20 minutes and I just wrote down absolutely everything that I needed to work on. That included kind of big projects, and then I broke all of those bigger projects down into all the small detailed tasks that needed to get worked on in order to fix to complete those bigger projects. And I think that's probably one of the most important things because we've all got loads of projects that we are working on and things that we need to do, and we tend to think about those in kind of the bigger picture. So for me, I'm writing my next book. So I would say, okay, I've got to write this book. Well, it's really difficult then to sit down in the morning and say, okay, I've got to write a book. Well, there's no real plan around it. Whereas you, if you break it down into all the different subtopics, all the different chapters, all the different areas, and say, all right, on Monday I'm going to write chapter one. On Tuesday I'll write, section three, whatever you're going to do. The same with, property investing. So if your project is to find your next rent-to-rent deal, you need to break that down into the steps of how you're going to find it. Are you, what different marketing strategies are you going to do? And what steps do you need to get to those happen? So if you want to put an ad in the newspaper, you've got to contact the newspaper, you've got to get their price list, you've got to create the ad, you've got to get a phone number, all of those different things. So it's spending a good amount of time upfront just breaking down all of your bigger projects into all of their step-by-step tasks. Once you've got all of those tasks done, then it's really easy to plan everything out into your week. So again, I set aside time every morning to write my book, but I don't just say I'm going to write a book. I say I'm going to work on this chapter, this topic, this subtopic. I then go on to say, all right, what am I going to do in the next part of the day. So I've recently been working really hard, as some of you'll probably know, on getting my bookkeeping organized and up to date. So I broke that down as well. So I said, all right, getting all of my accounts up to date, doing all my bookkeeping, that's a huge task. What does it actually break down into? So I had my gas bills, my electric bills, my Thames water bills, my payments to my staff. All of those different types of things that I needed to go through and sort out, I put them into, separate tasks. And then I put those into, all right, on Monday, my main focus was, my Eon energy bills. On Tuesday, my main focus was Thames water. So it's breaking it down so that you don't feel overwhelmed, because when I was just putting it on my to-do list that I needed to sort out my zero, sort out my bookkeeping, it just overwhelmed me and I never got anything done because it was too big to kind of comprehend sitting down and doing. I didn't know where to start. So it's all about making that plan and bringing it down to its kind of smallest, easy to manage level. And so again, every Sunday I sit down and I plan out my week, And I've got time set up every day, so from between, I think it's 8 and 10, I write in the book. Between 10 and 12, I focus on another task, and it's breaking your day up in specific times of when you're doing things, and then putting in the specific tasks that you're doing on that day at that time. So it's a shame, yeah. Facebook Live isn't made for kind of showing examples, or I'd show you an example of kind of what my diary looks like, what my task list looks like. Maybe I'll try to get some photos in after, but I've got to run off and work on some other stuff in a minute. But yeah, so it's just all about really sitting down and coming up with that plan. The most important part of your kind of day, your week, is the planning portion, because you can get so much more done if you've got a proper plan with how you're going to go about doing it. So if you don't have a plan for your week and you just say, oh, I'm going to get as much done as possible, then every time you want to start a new task, every time you start a new day, you've got to sit down and say, okay, what am I going to do today? Whereas if you make that decision on Sunday or Monday morning and you say, here's exactly what I'm going to do this week, here's exactly what I'm going to get accomplished, I've already broken it down into small bite-sized manageable chunks. Here's the couple of chunks that I'm going to get done today. Everything gets so much easier, and you feel so much more satisfied at the end of the day because you've broken it down into reasonable chunks that you can actually mark things off of your to-do list. So, again, if you've got a big task for me, like write a book, I can't just mark write a book off of my task in my to-do list every day. But because I've broken it down into chapters and sections, I can mark those off as I complete them every day. So it gives you that satisfaction. It makes you feel like you're reaching and you're getting towards the end goal, and it makes you feel like you're really accomplishing something for the day. Whereas if you just work and work and work and work on a bigger task, but you don't ever finish it, it can get quite demotivating sometimes. So make sure you break everything down into those small tasks. Plan out your week at the very, very beginning so that you know exactly what you're going to do. And you should start feeling a lot better, a lot more free, and you should start really seeing progress towards your goal. Hopefully you found that helpful. I've got to pop off and get my next bit done from my to-do list for today. So thank you so much for joining me, and we'll be back again tomorrow for another Live at Lunchtime.